In a bombshell development, South Australia's coronavirus lockdown will end early. From midnight tomorrow, businesses can reopen and we can leave our homes for any reason. Kids will be back at school on Monday. Tonight, permitted exercise is available, with thousands taking the opportunity to get some sun on a perfect spring day. There's a lot of ground to cover tonight. Our reporters are standing by to bring you the latest. First, though, to the extraordinary reason the rules are being relaxed. It all comes down to one young man. It's been revealed the COVID patient at the centre of the cluster lied to authorities, sending health officials scrambling in the wrong direction and a state into lockdown.
Carrying the fury of a state on his shoulders, the Premier unleashes.
To say that I am fuming about the actions of this individual is an absolute understatement.
A lie that brought South Australia to a standstill.
His actions have affected businesses, individuals, family groups, and is completely and utterly unacceptable.
The target of his ire, the Stamford Plaza Medi-Hotel worker, who had authorities fearing he'd caught the virus from a pizza box. He told contact tracers he'd bought takeaway from the Woodville South Pizza Bar, where two workers had tested positive. Today, though, a bombshell.
The person claimed that they'd purchased a pizza from the pizza shop, where in fact they were working there and had been working there for several shifts.
A deliberate deception which had authorities wrongly investigating a rare case of surface transmission and a different strain of the virus. They started tracking down delivery drivers and hundreds of customers.
Had this person been truthful to the contact tracing teams, we would not have gone into a 6-day lockdown.
The kicker? He can't be punished.
The Emergency Management Act requires people to provide information on request. There is no penalty for failing to truthfully answer those questions.
A legal loophole that's sure to change. For now, contact tracers are scrambling.
We are now dealing with a potential outbreak that we need to lock down as quickly as possible.
The business community seeing red.
This individual has held the state to ransom through telling a lie. And there's an economic and there's a social impact on that.
The hardship is not lost on us, and it's devastating that we've had to take this action on the basis of a false premise.
The silver lining is big.
Effective as of midnight on Saturday, the stay-at-home order will be repealed.
But we're not out of the woods yet. Three new cases today, all in quarantine, and there are more to come.
I just want to give people a little warning that we are expecting to see the number of cases here in South Australia rising over the next couple of days.
An expected development, she says, cause for concern, but not alarm. Mark Mooney, 7 News.
We join Mark live now at the pizza bar, which is tonight under police guard, Mark.
Yeah, it certainly is, Jane. In fact, officers have been keeping watch here ever since this morning's explosive press conference, and that is because of the furious reaction from people within the community aimed at both the pizza bar and the worker. In fact, there have been some very heated comments online, with some calling for a boycott of the business, others to vandalise it. While the police commissioner, though, says he understands the anger, he's urging people not to take matters into their own hands. A short time ago, he announced a special police task force to thoroughly investigate the pizza bar worker and his lies to contact tracers. 20 senior detectives and analysts will be given the job of determining if any crimes have been committed and, if so, lay charges.
We'll be investigating all of the circumstances relating to the information that was provided to contact tracing teams and the circumstances which have led to us being in the position we are now, so that we can make all proper inquiries.
He says Task Force Protect will leave no stone unturned. In fact, detectives have already begun work on this investigation. They are not messing around, Jane.
Thanks, Mark. South Aussies have welcomed news the enforced lockdown will be slashed in half. And with that exercise ban lifted immediately, these are the scenes at Henley Beach tonight. What a difference a day makes. Live now to Elspeth Hussey at Victoria Park. And Elle, it's been a popular decision, that one.
It absolutely has, Jane. As you say, our hard border lockdown will end at midnight tomorrow night, but South Aussies have wasted no time embracing the outdoors and getting back to exercise. The path here at Vic Park's definitely getting a bit of a workout this evening. There's joggers, walkers, cyclists. The mood is really upbeat. This was one of the more contentious restrictions. It was even tougher than the measures put in place in Victoria. You couldn't even walk your dog. But for us, it lasted little more than one day, and we now have back something that we perhaps took for granted.
From the beach to the city, these were the scenes moments after the announcement. Freedom never tasted so good.
Hooray, lockdown's over! Woohoo!
It feels so much better that I'm not stuck at home doing nothing, and it feels so much better to be out here roller skating.
Thousands of South Australians emerged from their homes and into the sunshine. Stir-crazy kids and cooped-up dogs couldn't believe their luck. This was the lockdown twist no one saw coming.
Effective immediately, exercise in family groups is now permitted.
It's great just to be out and have a walk and see the sun and certainly get the dog out.
And that's just the start. Our Victorian-style shutdown will now end tomorrow night. 3 days instead of six.
As of midnight Saturday, we will be reverting to a series of restrictions which are very similar to the ones that were imposed at the beginning of this week.
This is what we'll soon be able to enjoy again. Pubs, restaurants and cafes will reopen their doors for up to 100 people, tables with no more than 10. And you can have up to 10 people at your home. Hairdressers and beauty therapists will reopen too. Funerals can have up to 50 people and weddings 150, but no dancing. Spare a thought though for bride Azzie Ali, who's due to be married before the lockdown lifts.
Called my fiance to pick me up and I just go home. I'm crying for 2 days straight. I said this is not gonna be because we planned for our wedding since last year.
Universities will welcome back students from Monday. Schools will reopen too, just as parents were again getting their heads around homeschooling.
I get to be home all day.
But for parents, it's been a burden working from home while entertaining 24/7.
It definitely hasn't been easy. Finding things to do every minute of the day has definitely been challenging.
A challenge we could have avoided, but the Premier's making no apologies, even if the lockdown was triggered by a lie.
We would do exactly the same thing if we were presented with the same information again today. The reality is that there are no second chances.
And I was confident at the time that we made the decision to go into a 6-day lockdown, that it was the right course of action based on the health advice. That health advice was based on the information at their disposal, which we now know was not truthful.
1.67 million people in lockdown because of one. Elspeth Hussey, 7 News.
And we cross live now to Deanna Williams at Henley D. Police will still be watching our activities though.
Yes, they will be, Jane, especially places like this where you're likely to draw a crowd as the warm weather continues. Patrols were on the beach just a few minutes ago making sure people were doing the right thing. As you can see, it's not packed, but there are still plenty of people in family groups enjoying the fresh air and sunshine, riding their bikes and walking their dog, and importantly, keeping a respectable social distance and still wearing masks.
I think it's necessary to keep a bit of safe distance, but it doesn't hurt to get out and about.
Everyone's been like spacing away from each other and everyone's been following the restrictions really well.
But it could get tricky policing restrictions here with a hot Saturday ahead. While you can walk or swim, lounging around on towels is a no-no. And police are not holding back on issuing fines. They've raided a city apartment block at a party, seizing liquid fantasy and fining 7 people over the COVID breaches. So while we can enjoy some freedoms, there still are plenty of restrictions we need to abide by. Jane?
Thanks, Dee. Chief Reporter Mike Smithson's been following developments closely today. He's live in the studio with me now. And Mike, where does this bizarre day leave us?
Well, Jane, my head's still spinning. Today's developments are nothing short of extraordinary. Think about it. Every person in the state's been adversely affected. Businesses will have been decimated for 3 days. Health experts have been working on the crisis, many on a wild goose chase. Our fears have been building since last Sunday. And now we discover the reason for the lockdown is based on a lie. But it's not time to relax or let our guard down. The Parafield cluster remains. There are people in hospital and contact tracers are hunting down those who still pose a problem. So we've lowered the risk, but we haven't wiped it out. Health authorities trusted the hotel worker and assumed that he was telling the truth. But why did he feel the need to lie, given the damage it's caused? The lesson learned here, investigators into key suspects in the COVID chain must be more thorough. Penalties for lying need to be severe. So for the Marshall government, a law change is the next important task ahead. Jane.
Thanks, Mike. Businesses across the state are demanding compensation after losing millions as a result of the lockdown. For the hospitality sector, it's not just the loss of revenue. They've thrown out thousands of dollars worth of produce.
The lockdown will be over almost as quickly as it began, but for businesses across the state, the damage is done.
I think it's devastating for so many small businesses. Hospitality always seems to bear the brunt of these stop-start reactions, and hospitality always suffers the most.
In a devastating case of deja vu, pubs cleared out their fridges, knowing anything fresh wouldn't last 6 days.
All our perishables had to be thrown out. So fruit and veg, milk, eggs. So it's in the tens of thousands of dollars across our group.
This time, cafes were in the same boat, not even allowed to offer takeaway. Many are demanding compensation, saying it wasn't their choice to close.
We're supposed to be able to open on Sunday. How are we going to get staff in on Saturday to come and prep and get the shop ready again? We've got to get our supplies back, we've got to re-prep food, and we're supposed to bounce back without any compensation.
We need notice, we have to plan.
Gyms too say they can't keep up with restrictions. They were shut down Tuesday, even before the lockdown, but from Sunday they can welcome members back inside. So far, the government's rejected calls for compensation.
My priority is just opening up the economy as quickly as we can, and as of midnight on Saturday night, we will be moving back towards those reduced restrictions.
With many businesses no longer qualifying for JobKeeper or new state government grants, they feel like they're facing this second wave on their own. Andrea Nicholas, 7 News.
And we're joined now by Andrea live with news about purchase limits at supermarkets. Andrea, what's been announced?
Well, Jane, this is some really good news for shoppers after today's bombshell revelations. Both Woolies and Coles have been quick to remove buying restrictions on their products. They were put in place after thousands of panicked shoppers flooded supermarkets to stockpile just minutes after the drastic lockdown was announced on Wednesday. There were chaotic scenes as the shelves were stripped bare of the essentials. Woolies and Coles put 2-item restrictions on a range of fresh food items: meat, bread, eggs, long life milk, plus pasta and rice, toilet paper, disinfectants and hand wash. Thankfully, the panic buying didn't last long after calls for calm, and now shoppers are free to buy exactly what they want from the supermarket giants, Jane.
Thanks, Andrea. The Schoolies at Home event scheduled for tomorrow has been called off. Organisers say they don't want to push ahead if Year 12s aren't able to congregate at their homes with their friends. Schoolies at Home had been set up after the festival at Victor Harbour was cancelled. Fresh says it will look to reschedule the event to another date.